Hi everyone, it's me again, Sharon Ayala, and today I have a new pattern for you, and it's the Valentine's Teddy Bear with the heart-shaped feet. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to do the feet and the legs themselves, and then that way you guys can just get on with the pattern and you don't have to wait for me to finish filming the whole thing, because I'm in the middle of filming the full video tutorial, but it's going to take me another 3 or 4 days to finish, and today is February the 1st, Valentine's Day is February the 14th, so we don't have much time left, and I don't want to be holding anybody up. Okay, so you're going to head over to my blog and pick up the written pattern. In the written pattern, the supplies list is there, all the yarn weight and the hook size and everything. And the link to the pattern is in the description box below this video. So I hope you have fun, and if you do make yourself a little Valentine's teddy bear, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Emma Grimmie for Thee. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and have fun! Now we're working on the leg, and the leg is all one piece. The heart and the leg are one piece. We start right here and we work our way up, and we're going to end up switching colors along the way. So we begin with a loop with 6 stitches, that's row 1. Here for row 2 you can crochet the starting yarn tail into the second row just by holding along the edge and crocheting around it, or just leave it hanging and we can tuck it into the leg as we work along. And now you can add a marker into this last stitch you just put in. I'm going to wait till the end of row 2 to put in my marker. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. So going into the first stitch of row 2, go through, make sure you have 2 loops of that stitch on your hook. Grab your yarn, pull it through, and pull through. And that was 1 single crochet in the first stitch, and now we're going to go back into the same one and put another single crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Now we're going to go into the second stitch and do the same thing. There's 1. Now going back into the same stitch hole we were just in and put another single crochet. And there was 2 single crochets into the second stitch. Now we're going to go into the third one. There was 1, back into the same stitch, and there was 2. And that was 2 single crochets into the third stitch. Now we're going to go into the fourth one and put 2 single crochets. Now repeating that into the fifth stitch. 1 single crochet and back into this 5th stitch again and put another one. Now last time into the 6th stitch, put 2 single crochets. There's the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. I'm going to add in my marker now. It's going to go into that last stitch I was just in and pull a piece of yarn of a different color through that stitch. Okay, moving on to row 3, I'm going to work the entire row with you. We're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches, 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet into the second, and 1 single crochet into the third stitch. Now we'll put 3 single crochets into the next stitch. So go into the next one, put a single crochet, back in the same stitch you were just in, put another single crochet, and back into the same stitch, put a third single crochet. Now we'll put 2 single crochets into the next stitch, go into the next one, put a single crochet, and back into the same stitch, and put another single crochet. Now we will slip stitch the next 2 stitches. Slip stitch, you just go into the next stitch like you normally would, grab your yarn, and pull it through. And instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second one. And don't pull it too tight, because we're going to have to work into that these next 2 slip stitches in the next row. Now we're going to slip stitch the next one. Now we'll put 2 single crochets into the next stitch after that. 1
and two, three single crochets into the stitch after that, one, two, and three. Now I'll put one single crochet in the next three stitches. One, one, and you can see the third one's going to land on that marker, so I'm just going to pull the marker out and put in my last single crochet of the row. That ended row three, and now we have 18 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. Okay, moving on to row four, we're going to put a single crochet into the first stitch of the row. One single crochet. Now we're going to put a half double crochet into the next stitch. So a half double crochet, you just yarn over before going into that stitch. So yarn over and go in, grab your yarn and pull it through. Now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all three loops. And that was a half double crochet. So this here is my half double crochet. Right in here you can see how tall it is. I'm going to put a single crochet on the very top of this, and then I'm going to put a single crochet in the bottom. You can see the stitch hole there. So I'm going to bring my crochet hook through the top, through the back side, grab the yarn, pull it through, yarn over and pull through, and that was a single crochet on the top. And I'm going to go into the bottom and put another single crochet. Now we're going to put one single crochet in the next three stitches. Make sure you're not going back into the same stitches you were just working in. It's very easy to do that. So don't go back into the same one. Go into the stitch over. Put a single crochet in the next one. One single crochet in the next one. And one single crochet in the next one. Now I'll put two single crochets into the next stitch after that. One. And back in the same stitch for two. Now we'll put two half double crochets into the next two stitches. So remember to yarn over, go into the next stitch, pull your yarn through, you have three loops, yarn over and pull through all three loops. Now we're going to repeat that in the same stitch, yarn over. And that was two half double crochets into that one. Now we're going to go into the next stitch and do the same thing. Yarn over. That was one. And two. Put one single crochet into the next stitch. Now we're going to slip stitch the next two stitches. So you might have a little difficulty getting into the next stitch because we slip stitched in the previous row. So just try to push through, and if you can't push through, use your yarn needle and work at it until you can get your hook through it. There we go. And there was a slip stitch, and then we're going to do it again in the next one. Another slip stitch. Now we'll put a single crochet into the next stitch after that. Two half double crochets into the next two stitches. Remember to yarn over. There is one. And two. Now we're going to go into the next stitch and put another two half double crochets. One. And two. Now two single crochets into the next stitch. One and two. Now one single crochet in the next three stitches. One, whoops, one. Now the last one's going to land on that marker, so I'll pull the marker out. And one. And that was the end of row four, and now we have 26 stitches around. I'm going to move my marker. Ready for row 5, we're going to put a single crochet in the next 2 stitches. 1 and 1 single crochet in the next. Now for the remainder of the row, we're going to work in the back loops only. I'm going to show you what the loops are. So you can see there's the V of our stitch, and in that V there's 2 loops. There's the front loop, and that's the one closest to you. And then there's the back loop, and that's the one furthest from you. And that's the one we're going to work with to the end of the row. So I'm going to put 1 single crochet in the back loops. There was 1 going to the next back loop. A single crochet into the next back loop. So now I'm going into the dip of the heart here in the middle, and that's where we slip stitched in the previous row, so you might have to work at those a little bit. Get into the back loop. I'm about to put the back loop into that last stitch, and that's going to land on the marker, so I'll pull it out. And you can see the heart is starting to fold up on itself, so we're just going to turn it right side. This is the right side, and this is the wrong side, where that starting yarn tail is coming out of. You can see the difference, wrong side and right side. Now I'm going to move my marker. Okay, moving on to row 6, this is where we're going to switch colors. And we're only going to work in the next 3 back loops, and then we'll continue on with both loops again. So for row 6, we're going to put a single crochet in the next back loop. And now we're going to switch colors in the next back loop. I'm going to push through, grab our yarn, pull it through. Now we're just going to leave those loops on our hook, and we're going to hold the working yarn back here, put our finger over it to hold it in place. We're going to bring in our color change, and we're not going to do anything fancy with it. We're just going to lay it back there under the same finger. We're going to get ready to crochet on, switch fingers. Now pull the new color through those 2 loops. And you just switch colors. Now we're going to work in both loops again, and we're going to put a single crochet in the next 24 stitches. So that's to the end of the row when you land on the marker. Pull your yarn through. Now you can let go of those loops in the back. And just continue on working in both loops, 1 single crochet in those remaining stitches to the marker. So I'll continue on with the pattern, and I'll meet you back here at the end of the row. I just got to the end of row 6, I've moved my marker, and we still have 26 stitches around. I'm going to cut free from the red now. And I'll just leave those hanging there until I finish the next row, and then I'll stop and I'll knot off those 2 color changes. Row 7 is 1 single crochet in the next 11 stitches, then we're going to crochet 2 stitches together. So 1 in the next 11, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And now we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. So go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through, leave those loops on your hook, and go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through. Now you have 3 loops, yarn over, and pull through all 3 loops. Now you're going to repeat that sequence, 1 in the next 11, and then crochet the last 2 together. 1, 2, and 11. Now we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together, and you can see that second stitch is going to land on the marker, so I'm going to pull it out. And that completes row 7, and now we have 24 stitches around. I'm going to move that marker. I'm also going to stop and knot off those 2 color changes on the inside. I can cut those up a bit shorter. Now we're ready for row 8. We're going to put one single crochet in the next 4 stitches and then crochet 2 together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you'll be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. 1 in the first, 1 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth, and now crochet the next 2 stitches together. Go in, grab your yarn, pull it through, leave that loop on your hook, and go into the next stitch. Grab your yarn, pull it through. Now you have 3 loops, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Now keep repeating that sequence of 1 in the next 4 and then 2 together all the way around till you land on the marker. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we're finished this row. All finished row 8, and now we have 20 stitches around. I'm just going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. Just pull it out, leave it hanging, and I'm going to show you. You can add in a heart-shaped piece of plastic, and I got mine from this mesh sheet. I think it's called, plastic canvas. And you don't need this. If you don't have any, don't worry about it. This foot here has no plastic in it, and you can see it's held its shape pretty good. And I just put a little piece of yarn, just wrapped a little piece of yarn around the top to kind of pull that middle part down, and that defines it quite well on its own there. But if you want to add one of these, I can't tell you how to cut it because each foot is going to be a little bit different. You just want it to fit right inside this ridge right here. So you want to fit it in here. So when I push it in here, push it in. I'm going to make sure it's going right to this edge here. I'm going to pull the yarn, pushing my finger inside and pulling the yarn around it. And you don't want it too big, otherwise it's going to throw the shape off. So it's just got to fit just inside this ridge here where we crocheted in the back loops. Moving on to row 9, we're going to put one single crochet in each one of those 20 stitches for one row. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. One single crochet in each one of those 20 stitches. Finished row 9, and we still have 20 stitches around. Row 10 is one single crochet in the next 3 stitches and then crochet 2 together. Repeat all the way around till you land on the marker. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So I'll do the first set with you. One single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now crochet the next 2 stitches together. Now repeat that, one in the next 3, and then crochet 2 together all the way around till you land on the marker. Finished row 10, and now we have 16 stitches around. Row 11 is one single crochet in the next 6 stitches and then crochet 2 together. Repeat around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. So one in the next 6, that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and now crochet 2 stitches together, and now repeat that one more time, and when you land on the marker, you should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'll finish row 11, and now we have 14 stitches around. I'm just going to pull my last stitch so I don't lose it, and now we're going to stop and stuff the foot, and we're going to shape the foot. Now if you put plastic in there, you won't have to worry too much about shaping. But if you didn't have any plastic, then you have to pay a little bit more attention that you don't overstuff the foot, because then you'll lose its shape. And when I stuff the foot without the plastic in there, I just hold this dip in the heart, the top of the heart there, hold it down with my thumb, and then I push the stuffing in on each side of my thumb, and that just kind of helps hold its shape while I'm stuffing. But if you have the plastic in there, then I wouldn't worry about it too much. You just don't want to overstuff this part here, because then you will lose its shape. There we go. I'm going to add my marker. So rows 12 through 19 is one single crochet in each one of those 14 stitches for 8 rows. So I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 19. Just remember to move your marker at the end of every row. And if you don't feel like keeping track of your rows, every time you move that marker, put a notch on your notepad. And when you have 8 of those notches, then you'll know you're done, and we'll meet back here. One single crochet in each one of those 14 stitches for 8 rows. I'll finish row 19 and I'm going to pull up my last stitch so I don't lose it. And I'm going to stuff the rest of this leg now. And I'm only going to stuff up to about row 17 because I want a little bit of the last part of this leg to be flat. So I'm just going to put stuffing up to about row 17. So there's row 17 right there. So there's 17, 18, 19. I just want to leave that nice and flat. So when you sew the leg to the bear, of course you want the heart to be sitting right. So this will be the top part. So if it's sitting now, you want to make sure that it's going to sit upright. Then you fold the top part flat. So depending on where you're at with your last single crochet that you just put in, you just want to finish off by crocheting right through both sides. So I folded it flat. I'm going to go through both sides. Right to the end. For me, that was just once. And I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to turn. And I'm going to crochet through both sides of the leg. All the way across. Okay, I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to single crochet across that top edge. And now I can finish off. I'm going to leave a bit of a tail for sewing. I'm going to use this tail to sew the leg to the body. Let's pull that yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. So that's the end of this tutorial. Hope you had fun, and I hope this helped get you through the most difficult part of the pattern. And if you did make yourself a little Valentine's Day teddy bear, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon.